Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to talk about adoption. I'm Rita and today it's all about you. Adoption is the process where a person takes legally and permanently the parental responsibility for a child. If this child has any kind of responsible tutors or guardians, all these rights end in the beginning of the adoption. Adoption can be not only for a child, but also for adults too. Most of the people want to adopt a child for two reasons. The first one is a social altruistic motive, which usually is this feeling of wanting to give an opportunity to a certain child, a chance in life, or for a very specific situation that the child is living, particularly social disadvantaged cases. The second reason is to fight a natural cause that certain people suffer that doesn't allow them to have a natural birth child. For a child that is expecting to be adopted, the expectations to have a close relationship with this new family can develop feelings of belonging and even a higher self-confidence and self-esteem. And these expectations are really high. But most of the adoptive individuals feel challenged about identity and abandon issues due to the pre-adoption times. There are a very high number of traumatic experiences that can happen that can translate in a very negative view of the whole adoption process. Adoption is not just a complex bureaucratic system. It can also be a struggle for different kind of issues like identity formation, cope with loss, abandonment, trauma, psychological disorders, and behavior challenges that can happen only through adulthood or during the childhood development. But adoption also have myths and stigmas associated, like the myth that a child that has adopted have always to be grateful to their adoptive parents, or that parents can't really love an adoptive child as their own. But the truth is that an adoptive family can be as destructed or structured as any other family. A person that can have a close, honest and respectful relationship with their adoptive parents may eventually achieve a higher state of security about themselves and their identity and grow up happy and well adjusted. An adopted child can experience bonding and attachment issues, as well as problematic behaviors like violence, defiance and aggressiveness. A sense of grief and loss related to the birth family can cause PTSD, and some of these behaviors are just to test the limit to the new family and try to find out if they are gonna be abandoned again, which at the same time can cause shame and the need of control and the need of self-regulation. Adoption is not something that is the same for every situation, for every family, for every child. And if there are situations where the child can feel supported and nurtured by the adoptive families, there are also other situations where the child is struggling with feelings of misplaced, abandonment, guilt, grief, abuse and trauma. It always depends on the parent's behavior and the parent's emotional growth. In their personal stories, in their personalities and in their past experiences. Placing a child for adoption is a complex, serious emotional process. Most of the parents feel guilt, sadness, and regret, and even feel the whole grief stages. But others feel totally secure about their decision, and they really believe that their child will have a different opportunity, a better life, and a better future with another parent and with another living situation. And so for this big decision, it is important and even vital that the parents have an emotional support to help make these kind of decisions and to understand if this is what they really want and if their expectations are going to be fulfilled. Most of the times, the foster care institution is the first step toward adoption. But it is also important to understand that a child that is too long in this kind of institution and is too long in the foster system have more needs. It is a really bigger challenge, particularly for them as a child, and also unfortunately have a bigger chance to have PTSD still during childhood. This is a very complex topic. This is something that we have lots of things to talk about it. That's lots of specific situations that can conduct to a traumatic experience that can really lead to psychological marks for the rest of the child life. But there are also other kind of situations where things run kind of smooth and a child can have a happy ending. Of course, we here just want to talk about the main topics about adoption and alert for the main psychological issues. Of course, there are lots of other issues that a bad experience can bring, but if you think during childhood there are lots of other bad experiences or experiences that they are not so positive and that they cannot be related to adoption, that can also be a traumatic experience for a child too. So in this case, the advice is always to, in any situation, always involve some kind of mental health provider, particularly one that is much more used to work with children. So probably a pedopsychiatrist or a pedopsychologist, somebody that has a special way of dealing with children, because if it is a special situation for parents, it is much more serious and much more problematic for a child, particularly if this child is not a baby any longer and if it's not a toddler any longer, and if she will develop memories of this situation in the future. So there are lots of other prospects and expectations about this issue. So my advice is if you know or if you are dealing with this kind of situation, try to find some mental care advice first, because it is important for you to know exactly what you are doing as a parent, what is your role as a parent, and what kind of child situation can you have in the future, what kind of relationship you can build with your adopt child. And so that's all for today, guys. I hope you like it. I hope you subscribe to the channel, leave a thumbs up, share with a friend, comment if you want, and I'll see you next time for another video. Bye.